Good morning, students. Today we will learn that how to draw a cone which is resting on its base on the top of a surface of the cube. Right, this is the question. A cone of height 40 mm and base diameter 15 mm is resting centrally on a cube of side 20 mm. Draw its isometric view. So first of all, we will see that what is a cone. The cone, base of a cone is a circle, the top is a point. Right? So first of all, let's draw base. Diameter is given 15 point UID. Right, from the center, you will draw a line straight vertical upward equal to the height of the cone. Height is given 40 point UID. Right. So this point is connected with the circumference of the circle here. So that's how it appears. You can see this is the height, this is the height, and this is a base. Now it is given in the question that this cone is resting on the cube centrally, the center of the top surface of a cube, right? So side of a cube is given 20 mm. So first of all, draw a cube. All the sides of cube are equal, we know, right? So first of all, make sure that this 5 tools, dynamic input, ortho mode, object snap, trend, line weight. These 4 tools and 5th tool, this one. This is called isometric drafting tool or iso draft tool. Right? This should be on. So first of all, select line command and draw line in this direction. If you are unable to draw line in this direction, click on this arrow and click on isoplane top in this direction, 20, because side of the cube is given 20, so this will be 20 point UID, right? Next line in this direction, 20 point UID. Next in this direction, 20 point UID. Next in this direction, 20 point UID, right? So this is the base of the cube. Now draw the perpendicular. Now draw the perpendicular. If you are unable to draw the perpendicular, from here you can select isoplane left or right. Draw vertical lines. They should be also 20 point UID. From all the 4 corners, 20 point UID. Similarly, from this corner upward, 20 point UID. Even from this corner, 20 point UID. Right, join with these endpoints of the line. Yeah. Right, so this is a cube. Also join the diagonal. Join these diagonals. This is a cube of side 20 point UID. If you measure this, this is 20 point UID. Now this is the top surface. Now base of this circle is resting here on the center of this surface, right? How to change, how to draw this base here on the center of this top surface? First of all, we must know that the isometric view of the circle is an ellipse. Isometric view of circle is an ellipse. When you are drawing its base here, first of all, you have to draw the rectangle. But now here base is a circle. So whenever you will try to enclose it in a rectangle, it will be a square. You have to enclose it in a square. I mean, all sides are equal. All sides equal to 15.67. Right? 15.67. In this direction, you can draw a iso top if this is a square, so 15.67 on this side, 15.67 on this side, 15.67 on this side, 15.67 on this side. Join their diagonals. Join their diagonals. Right. You have to enclose an ellipse inside this square. The side of this square is 15.UID. This is 15.UID. All the sides are equal. Join their diagonals. Dear students, if you measure its diagonal, this one, this diagonal, this will be equal to the side of the square, and it will be always this will be equal to the side of the square, right? Even we have taken this, all the sides are equal 20.UID, right? So here this diagonal will be equal to 20.UID, means side of the square, right? Now how to place this at the center, how to place this here at the center? If half of this diagonal, calculate the half of this diagonal, it will be 7.835, 15.UID divided by 2, right? You can find out the calculator. Calculator, if you divide 15.67 divide by 2, this is 7.835, right? It will be 7.835, means half of this diagonal from the center to upward. So now draw a line, vertical line from the center. From the center. Here this is the midpoint, so vertical line equal to 7.835, and now you have this point. Now draw a line in this direction, select here isoplane top, here in this direction side is equal to 15.67, similarly in this direction 15.67, now in this direction 15.67, now in this direction 15.67, right? So now you have to enclose an ellipse inside this. How to draw ellipse here? You have to select arc type, start and direction. This start and direction. Select here start and direction. One click here on the midpoint of this, midpoint of this side. Second click here at the midpoint of this side, right? Third click here at this corner. Corner of the square. Again, same arcs, start and direction. Now click here at this endpoint, click here at the midpoint of this, and second, third click here at the corner of this square. Start and direction, one click here at the midpoint, second click here at the midpoint of this side, third click here at this corner of the square. Again, start and direction arc. One click here, second click here, third click here at the corner of the arc. Right. So this is the ellipse. This is the base of the. This is the base of the cone. Right. Now, what is the top of the cone? We have already seen the top is the point. So from the center, you will draw vertical line. From the center you will draw vertical line, and its length will be equal to the height of the cone, 40.UID, right? And with the help of line command, join it here. Similarly, again select line command, join it here. Right. Now, dear students, some sides are visible from the direction and others are hidden. Right. So, which are hidden? right? Some part of this ellipse on the back side, this is hidden, and some part of this cube is hidden. First of all, trim this part of the cube. This is hidden. Trim it. Now select line command. From here select isoplane top. You can also press F5 to change the direction of the line. In this direction to any length, draw a line. Right. Similarly, for starting from this point, draw a line on this side to any length. Now trim these extra lines. Trim these extra lines. Now this part of the line and this part of the line and some part of this arc, they should be hidden. So how to hidden? Click on other, go to this third bilayer, click on other, right, click on load and search here hidden tool line. This one is a hidden tool line. Click on this, OK and OK. Now select these lines and select this arc, click on hidden tool. Click on hidden tool, these lines will become hidden. Hidden tool, right? And also this line, these lines should be hidden. Make them hidden tool. This line should be hidden tool. Right, and this line is called center line. So first of all, load the center tool line, click on other, click on load and search your center tool line. Here this is the center tool line, center 0.5x. okay, click on this line and make it center tool line, because this is show the center. Now lines which are visible, they should be thick. So select these lines, select this line of the square first of all, this side. The thickness should be 0.80. See the thickness 0.80. Right. And this part of the arc. And these lines of cone, these lines should be 0.80. And other line, show the dimensions first. This line should be 40.UID. Right. At the side of the square, this should be 15.UID. You can decrease the size of the text. First of all, make them 0.05. These lines should be thin. They are thin lines because they are not part of the drawing. They are drawn only to show the dimensions. You can decrease the size of the text. D enter, click on modify and decrease the size of the text. So your figure is complete. You can save it in PDF. This was drawing sheet number 8.2. Okay, dear. Thank you very much.